Mr. Dr. Jitendra Singh Lt, because it is a very timely conference. The two new Union Territories are embarking on a historical new path. This is the time when new governance paradigms can be set, new culture can be set, and we can try and achieve the target given by the Honorable Prime Minister, which is of minimum government and maximum governance. It is absolutely great to know that almost 19 states and union territories are participating in this conference. I am sure that their collective learning, their collective wisdom, the learnings that they have in good governance would benefit both new union territories. I would look forward to their deliberations, their advice, their suggestions on how to deliver the best possible results for the people of Union Territory of Ladakh. I would like to thank Secretary Shri Chandramouli, who has made such huge efforts to put this conference together, and with this novel thought in mind that he should be able to help the two Union Territories in their new journey. I am once again very thankful to Dr. Jitendra Singh for the very good thought of holding such a conference, which I am sure would help Union Territory of Ladakh in a very big way. I would look forward to the findings, the recommendations of this conference, and try to use them for the benefit of our people. Once again, many, many thanks to everybody.
Actually, walk the talk. We stand with the gate. Prime Minister Modi and his government stands with the gate. And being a student of science, I would not say without evidence, just for the sake of saying, so that you also go home and say, ki kuch na kuch to kehna tha, Chief Guest was kehte to keh diya. I'll qualify in a moment. What is the essence of maximum governance? Maximum governance, A, would mean more and more of transparency. We have talked, we have walked the talk with evidence, I said. On the 15th of August 2015, from the ramparts of the Red Fort, Prime Minister Modi announced that he wanted interviews to be abolished for appointments to the government, so that there could be a level playing field for the youth, regardless of whichever socio-economic strata he came from. And he said, jab interview ki call aati hai, to ghar mein bhunchal aa jata hai. Kahan se sifarish hoti. And I am proud to say, because if I don't pat my back, who else would? If I don't pat the back of my DOPT, who else would? The office, the media is looking forward for some juicy criticism. So I have no hesitation to compliment the DOPT that within 3 months, this exercise was completed and a circular was issued. And on the 1st of January of the following year, 2016, the interviews were done away for the appointments to the doorposts, most of the non-vested posts. Unfortunately, some of the states did not pick up that, including Jammu and Kashmir, where it happened only after the abrogation of Article 370. And that's a separate issue when you narrate the advantages mentioned by General Moyli also, which is rather unavoidable, particularly as BVR was mentioning, in a real-time age that we live. Over the 5 years, we have done what was not done earlier, which could have been done earlier, because preparing reforms for others to emulate. We virtually today have online portals for every service being provided by the Government of India, starting from the DOPT. We have online portals not only for the service class, whether it's a PPO, your pension order, whether it's an e-service book. We have online portals for RTI. And the day it was launched, I said in a lighter vein that some of the RTI activists who were always itching to file an RTI have to wait for the office to open. But took care, we have given you an app, we have given you a motor mobile. So, kuch logon ka gyan udhe raat ko 12 baje ke baad hota hai. You can get up and file an RTI wherever you are sitting. From wherever you are. You've done this. The states had a grievance cell as a requirement or a formality, but the website had not been visited for 2 years. We activated the grievance cell in the Ministry of Personnel and then tried to persuade others to follow our example. When we came in 2014, the number of grievances being registered per year was just about 2 lakhs. Today, 5 years later, it is, as we calculated on the 31st of December, it is 16 lakh more than that per year. So it's gone up 8 times. And when I said so, one of the media persons sardonically asked, and I like to be grilled because that gives me an opportunity to grill them. He said, कहीं ऐसा तो नहीं है कि मोदी सरकार के खिलाफ शिकायतों की संख्या बढ़ती जा रही है जो आप कह रहे हैं कि 2 लाख से 16 लाख होगा तो मैंने कहा कि इसका उत्तर देने की आवश्यकता नहीं क्योंकि इसका उत्तर बाबा गालिब 150 साल पहले दे गए जब उन्होंने ये शेर कहा कि जब तवक्को ही उठ गई गालिब क्यों किसी का गिला करे कोई यू फाइल अ ग्रीवेंस वेयर यू हैव द होप ऑफ रिसीविंग रिड्रेसल और डिस्पोजल एंड सिंस वी हैड मेड आर ग्रीवेंस सेल्स वेबसाइट्स इनएक्टिव डिफंक्ट सिक द सिटीजन लॉस्ट इंटरेस्ट And we really worked hard for it because, as I said, if we don't bat our back, who else would? I'm saying so in the hope that if not 100, at least 10 would feel inspired about what has been done in the last 5 years.